Namaste everyone. Apart from the globally recognized merits of accreditation, the new education policy has laid far higher emphasis on accreditation. And in this module, we present the expert views on the role of faculty members for ensuring a better score on the key quality indicators under the accreditation process carried by the NAC. Our views encompass both tactical and strategic initiatives. So, I would like to emphasize that reading the NAC Institutional Accreditation Manual is a prerequisite for taking maximum benefit from this module, and therefore, please read it prior to taking up this module.
Namaste everyone. Based on my experience, today I will share my views on two very important criteria of NAC accreditation process: curricular aspects and teaching, learning and evolution. The focus will be on how faculty members of an institution can play a vital role to ensure a better score on the key quality indicators of these criteria. Curricular aspects includes practices of an institution in initiating a wide range of program and courses that are in tune with the emerging national and global trends and also relevant to the local needs. In addition, it also includes diversity and academic flexibility, aspects of career orientation, multi-skill development, feedback system, and involvement of stakeholders in curricular design and updations. The first thing, as a member of BOS and academic committee, senior faculty members have to ensure that curriculum of an institution should have considerable focus on employability, entrepreneurship, and skill development. Besides, they can also ensure that the content of structure of the course should be regularly updated and should be in tune with the emerging national and global trends. Here, I suggest that one can benchmark some reputed institutions in India or abroad and also look to add some topics which are unique and purposeful. While designing and implementing any new program and course, faculty can ensure that each of them is clearly structured and reflects program specific outcomes and course outcomes. Here, a proper mapping of them results better evaluation and control. Next is to ensure that regular incorporation of elective courses should be encouraged to provide students academic flexibility in the institution. Although all institutions have adopted CBCS and elective based system, but in case your institution has not done this, you may take collective efforts to present the adoption in upcoming academic council meetings. Inclusion of value added courses imparting transferable and life skills are very important for holistic development of students. Faculty should ensure that incorporation of such courses should be outside of the discipline. They can orient their students to enroll in such value-added courses according to their interest as much as possible. Faculty can encourage their students to take maximum participation in field projects. The participation of all stakeholders, alumni, students, parents, employers in revision and redesigning of curricula should be fortified. Encourage your office or develop a system to collect and analyze feedback of all stakeholders to enhance the learning effectiveness. Teaching, learning, even evolution pertains to the efforts of an institution to serve students of different background and abilities through effective teaching learning experiences. It includes student enrollment of profile, student diversity, teaching learning processes, teacher profile and quality, evolution process and reforms, student performance and learning outcomes, and student satisfaction survey. First, to ensure representation of student community from different geographical area, socio-economic, cultural and educational backgrounds, one can take help of print and digital media platform while announcement of admissions. Besides, faculty with support of management can also play a role in development of institutional environment culture which favors and attract wide variety of students. One can also play special efforts to bring in students from special categories, reach out of their special learning needs by initial assessment of their learning level. Next is to develop learner-centered education through appropriate methodologies such as participative learning, experiential learning, and collaborative learning, modes which ultimately facilitate effective learning. Further, teacher can take help of digital resources, develop learning management system for teaching, so learning have become easy, always available, individualized, and creative and dynamic. They can use of interactive instructional techniques that engage students in higher order thinking and investigation through the use of interviews, focused group discussions, debate, projects, presentations, experiments, internship, and application of ICT resources. They can take active part in research and other societal program at state, national, and international level so that they can get awards, recognitions time to time. Teachers can also take initiative to learn and keep abreast with the latest development to innovate, continuously seek improvement in their work, and strive for individual institutional excellence. Teachers who focus on excellence eventually win some awards, but remember that you should have proper documentation with you so that the institution can easily put the data and documents as required in standard operating procedures of NAC. They can encourage practices of innovative evaluation process at various levels of the program. Teachers on their part can evaluate examination sheet accurately and well on the time so that the evaluation process can be improved without any flaws. Teachers should also encourage management of institution to adopt automation to conduct examination and declaration of the results. Develop automated platforms which can accurately map and evaluate the performance of students in terms of attainment of program outcome, program specific outcome, and course outcomes. To improve output of student satisfaction survey, teachers can increase participation of students in teaching, examination, course curricula related matters. They can also encourage students to participate student feedback well within the time. Please remember that if we constantly focus on providing better experiences to the student, they would always rank their institution higher. Hopefully, the experiences under both the criteria that I shared could be helpful to you. Thank you.
I am here to discuss two very important criteria that are there in NAC, criteria 3, which involves research, innovation, and extension, and criteria 4, which involves infrastructure and learning resources. Both of these criteria, if you see it very aptly, it requires a very long-term planning and involvement and has to be improved continuously to achieve a good score. It is not that it is an one-time affair and can be done very quickly. When we look at the distribution of weightages across the three indicators, we find that criteria 3, that is research, innovation, and extension, this carries the maximum weightage of 250. This is followed by criteria 2, which is teaching, learning, and evaluation, which carries 200 weightage, and criteria 1, curricular aspects, which carries 150 weightage. All the other criteria have a weightage of 100. So, as you can see that the importance of criteria 3 is very much there because it has the highest weightage. And research, extension, and innovation are one of the prime factors that can actually improve the score of the university. Within criteria 3 itself, when we see in details, there are 7 KIs or key indicators. They are promotion of research and facilities, research mobilization for research, innovation ecosystem, research publication and awards, consultancy, extension activities, and collaboration. Here, as expected, research publications and awards have been given the highest weightage of 100, followed by extension activities 40, and then innovation ecosystem, that is 30. All the other indicators have a research weightage of 20. In research publication and awards, publication including journal papers, book chapters, etc. are most important, but here one has to keep in mind that all of these publications should be in a indexed database like Scopus, Web of Science, or the Indian Citation Index. Now, patents have also been given some importance by the government, and patents either published or awarded are to be noted and provided to the NAC, and it is also important that all faculty members produce some amount of PhDs or enroll a good number of PhD students as accepted by the UGC standards under them. This also has a very good weightage. Bibliometrics are generated by NAC, so it has to be seen that within these indices, the university is well represented and the names of the universities match with those that are given in publications by the individual faculty. Extension activities are generally ignored by researchers, but NACS gives a very high weightage to this of about 40, and this cannot be ignored. It can be regularly done by students and the faculty in the neighborhood community and will help achieve a very handsome score. If the university has a NSS, NCC and some collaborative activities with the government recognized bodies, then such type of extension activities can be regularly conducted. Innovation ecosystem, which has a weightage of 30, has to be worked out rigorously, as the highest weightage is given to the number of startups which are incubated. So, having an incubation center in the university would help, and also students all across the university in different courses, be it whether PG, UG or PhD, should be encouraged to promote the entrepreneurship activities, and some workshops and seminars can also be regularly arranged. This will of course help to build up the innovation ecosystem of the university, and ultimately some of the students and faculty members can also start winning awards in these activities, which will then be weighted highly within the NAC criteria. Resource mobilization has always been highly awarded. Resource mobilization in research from government and non-governmental sources should be attempted more by the faculty members, and maximum number of faculty members and maximum number of departments should be involved in resource mobilization. It can be seen that when applying for institutional projects, a large number of departments collaborate so that it can be seen that the university as a whole is actively involved in research. Consultancy is again one of the most ignored activities in the university, and other than the revenue generated through consultancy, what can help over here is that one can achieve some amount of score by arranging for training for corporate personnel, which will then of course be weighted well. But overall, it can be seen that if one tries to improve the collaborative activities, one tries to improve the entrepreneurship quotient and the innovation ecosystem, and manage to get some funds from the government and also the non-government sources, then the whole research environment will go up in the university. In criteria 4, which involves having the infrastructure improvement for learning resources, physical facilities, IT infrastructure has a weightage of 30 each, whereas library infrastructure and maintenance of all the campus infrastructure is weighted at 20. In physical infrastructure, evidences of all the classroom, laboratories, facilities for sports, games and cultural activities, ICT enabled infrastructure need to be geotagged. This has to be provided both as photographs and as video. It is also to be taken care of that the budget allocation augmentation should be carried out regularly so that these type of activities are seen for NAC. For IT infrastructure, student computer ratio, frequency of updation of availability of Wi-Fi, bandwidth of internet connection is of high priority. In the library, mostly we see that nowadays automation is there, but frequency of library visit by the faculty and students should be maximized. Nowadays, it is seen that because library resources are available online and mostly also off campus, most of the faculty and students do not regularly visit the library, but for NAC purposes and also for the betterment of the library, it should be encouraged mostly by the students. Collection of rare books and manuscripts can be promoted, and the library should have a good collection of e-journals and e-books. Annual expenditure on the library for the purchase of books and journals is also very highly weighted. For maintenance of campus infrastructure, both expenditure of the maintenance excluding salary and having established systems of maintenance is equally weighted. Overall, it should be kept in mind that NAC is not only about scoring, but about improving the teaching and learning environment of the institutions to bring it at par with the best. Thus, all out efforts should be made for continuous improvement, and that should be the mantra.
Student support and progression. Now, this includes student support, progression, participation and activities, and alumni engagement. Now, the first thing is to orient your office in the department to keep record of students who are receiving scholarships. And please note that most of the scholarship applications are routed through the office, and it is easy to keep the track. Now, next is to ensure that the students are oriented to share their achievements of campus placement offers, awards, recognition, research, or other papers with the office, and you should develop an incentive and recognition mechanism, which could be as simple as a separate notice board on which achievements or paper or the placements are well recognized, or even appreciating the students on social media, that can also be considered. Connecting with alumni is extremely important, and for a variety of reasons this is there, and one good way to connect is social media, but please do this strategically. And remember that if we are known as a good teacher and have a good reputation on the online world, our ex students would be happy to connect. And you may also make a team of students that keeps touch with their seniors to collect information about clearing competitive examinations. And such students could also be invited for interaction sessions that would serve multiple benefits. Now, we can also take initiative to propose coordinating alumni meet at a location convenient to students and facilitate creating alumni chapters in some prominent cities and even outside the country. So, if you consider these suggestions, you will find that over the years, alumni would have a tremendous contribution to the progress of the university. Now, point number four is to discuss in the department about conducting career counseling and guidance sessions on competitive examination. Now, please also ensure that you have suitable photographs and a brief report of the session. Print Media Connect is also very helpful. Now, these programs benefit the students, and you could organize them occasionally, and they can be shared with the newspapers. And as a faculty member, we should realize that we have a key role in ensuring the placement of our students. So, we should link the placement cell and do our best to improve the recruitment number. Now, let us come to the criteria on institutional values and best practices. The key indicators of this criterion are institutional values and social responsibilities, best practices, and institutional distinctiveness. Promotion of gender issues is considered very important, and faculty members should jointly identify the themes on which such programs could be organized. Now, let me tell you that this is a very nice way to connect with prominent people and organizations which otherwise would have been difficult. Now, thus, such programs serve the dual purpose. We can meet relevant people in university and sensitize them to recognize eco-friendly actions. We may also try to involve students and propose some easy actions that could improve the usage of solar power, plantation, various green practices, and reduce the paperwork. And I tell you, students will be happy because such assignments give them a linkage with internal evaluation, which you may consider, and recognition by senior authority of the university. So, you have to ensure that this way you are able to link up the things. Now, in this criterion, please remember that high emphasis is given on best practices and institutional distinctiveness, and therefore, we can identify them and involve all the relevant people to improve on their delivery, so that in couple of years, the merit of such practices is very obvious, and do not forget to ensure social media coverage. Finally, teachers and students should join hands for social projects. For instance, at FMS and Faculty of Law at Banasthali, we have linked a mandatory social project with continuous evaluation. Now, the social project involves working on financial literacy, digital literacy, legal literacy, environment issues, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, Fit India, etc. Our experience says that this initiative has not only helped the environment and poor people, but students have understood the joy of helping the society, and they could also assess if they would like to make their career in social sector. So, imagine the merit of this exercise and come up with such innovative ideas which could be shared with the government. And you know, we have made some project proposals that could be submitted under the STRIDE and the IMPRESS schemes based on the preliminary work carried by the students. So, the experiences under both the criteria that I have discussed could be used to frame case studies that could be improved upon and then sent for publication in Scopus, Index, journals as well. Friends, I trust our views prove useful for you. And if you need any further advice, please write to us on prime@banasthali.in. Thank you very much.